This one is 2% copper and 0.5 nickel.
Can we request that you write the percentages down
you
so that we
can
copy them? I mean, write them down on the paper so that we can get them.
Because then we'll take a photo of them. But now,
I'll write them down. So you can ask and I'll say yes all day.
Well, this might be super nice if it was if these were soaked in acid, or if we had less. See, they are completely encased in crystals. So this might be better if we lowered the amount of soaking to get.
Yes.
You want some blank spaces.
I was a little mystified by why we're getting so much over crystallization.
Yeah, you got a lot, so.
Yeah, and it was the same firing.
Because you kind of want like
base.
This, where you have the back, you want to have the background a little.
If you want that, can you increase the flux just a little bit to make it run a little more?
Probably, or increase the heat, or slow down, you know, don't do as much soaking. Probably a lot of the soaking, because this has run off really well.
Oh, yeah.
So increases the flux may help, but it's I would work with the firing cycle myself.
Yeah, I think so. That one's just 5% titanium added to the samir
See,
base.
This is another method people can use. They just put this on, and then they'll paint washes of cobalt or chrome or whatever on there, and then it gets in there weird. And they also use sulfates, like copper sulfate, cobalt sulfate, because then that goes in there real good.
And all the little cracks?
Well, it's on top before it's fired.
Oh, okay.
Before it's fired. And then or you could put another glaze on this and refire. And you get good.
What I mixed up?
The samir?
This is your titanium.
Okay, so it's 5%.
5% titanium.
Fantastic, nice, thank you.
And I actually don't know what these two are because I just dipped in something you mixed.
Oh, it smells best. Was it from
yesterday? Yes, and you called them. It was yesterday, but you called them number 3 and number 4.
This is probably nickel and amber. Yeah.
First day.
Yeah.
Okay.
And so it doesn't really matter that much. They're
uninteresting.
Well, Bill's best 3 is what this is.
So then they correspond to the assignment.
Yeah.
3 and 4.
Yeah.
For
okay.
Macro.
Yeah. Right. Very good. Okay. Who's this?
Me.
What do we got? We know what this is.
Oh, yeah. This is the Fa.
Fa base?
Yeah.
Ray Fa.
Ray Fa.
What is
Ray
this? MN 2%?
I don't know.
Manganese.
This is not me. I don't know who wrote that.
Well, we wrote that because we thought that's what it was. It says
okay.
It says here.
It's whatever the base is. Okay.
Yeah, it says here.
Yeah.
4 titanium.
And then the manganese.
2 manganese. It's manganese, not magnesium on this sheet, by the way. It says number 6, it's manganese, not magnesium.
So is it wrong?
Typo, yeah. Typo.
I'm sorry, which page is that?
Yeah.
And that's Bill's best one.
And you would know this if you were a potter, because you would know that below the line is, well, I mean,
your color.
Below the line are the colorants. So you know that's just a
plain
zebra.
Oh,
I know.
It's really black.
You can tell real easy.
Yeah.
Look at the color
yeah.
of the white blaze.
It's one, two,
it'll
three.
Either be black.
So actually, I know the green looks the best. I think it's
white,
got the
yeah.
background and it's got the.
How much
the
does it call
out?
For Ray Fong?
What was 1, 2, 3?
So this is one.
Coat,
top,
two
top
coats,
right.
and three
two
coats.
Coats. Yeah.
Okay, so this is what she had done the first day, and
so.
she did 1, 2, and 3 coats, and decided yeah, she liked
it. Should
it.
Still be a dark
so that's what
wet glaze.
So she reproduced
manganese.
And that's with three
pretty
coats.
Intense.
Three.
Yeah.
So she did. She put
fantastic.
Manganese.
Yeah.
Not
so
manganese.
2%. Or wait,
only
no,
on the
no,
one that she
did.
So did you put manganese or magnesium?
What? This one, she only, she
this
just threw it away.
Really?
This is spectacular, by the way.
Manganese, okay.
I don't know if you guys know this.
Yeah,
this
right.
is spectacular.
Yeah.
You don't get that, like, I've never gotten these things myself till we did this. So the fact that we now have a table full of this, I'm telling you, this is spectacular.
Yeah.
Good job.
So
is
that
this is beautiful,
done
too.
With the typo?
Yeah, it's a typo.
Okay.
Yeah, well, she's asking,
no,
was
no,
this actual
no,
one used
was.
Manganese
thing,
well, or
did
magnesium?
The right
I
stuff.
Made it with manganese,
yeah.
magnesium.
Okay.
She knew what it was, yeah.
Yeah. And then that's that.
I love that. What's that?
It's number 5?
Samir.
Samir.
Yeah.
Samir's number 5.
With
the titanium and iron, and then what else happened?
It's a 1, 2, 3.
Oh, thin, medium, thick.
Mm-hmm.
So thin, medium, and thick. On stone, porcelainous stone,
that,
or stone.
That looks like B-mix.
B-mix.
And what clay is this?
That is B-mix? B-mix, yeah. If it's whiter, it's porcelain. This is porcelain. That's porcelain. That's the 5S porcelain.
This is just Samir's?
5S.
Or S5 or whatever. I got it from you.
Oh, maybe S porcelain?
Yeah, the S porcelain.
Okay, okay.
Is the same recipe on both of these?
From you.
Different.
Well, I mean, you sold me a ton.
Don't you remember that?
But that was a special order, and I do remember because I'm going, hey, I'm always portraying out of porcelain, so that might be a little more blue white than what else. But we got our arcs, so now we got a really good porcelain.
At Trinity?
Yeah. We finally got the plugs in.
Yeah.
Spotless.
All right, thank you. Very nice. A job well done. Next victim.
We almost got one.
It was like wrapped in bags. You touch it and you're dead.
Police are, if you guys, they're ticketing today. If you're about to unload, before you do it, we'll call, okay?
Okay. I don't know about that row on the far left, because those were the mixes that we put together last week. But from the ones in your hand over the next three, this, those are three different clay bodies. All we did was we took the BC Matte 1.
Okay.
With the Richland and Red Iron Oxide blend that was the number 4 on your list of instructions. And we played with the amount of rutile. So where we added more rutile, and then we took rutile away.
Okay.
That's the only difference. So we just wanted to see what would change when we changed the amount of
rutile. So here's the most, and here's the least. So she's getting more milky, creamy. This is more irony.
Right.
Very good.
We like the, I mean, we didn't get much in the way of crystals, but we liked the colorant, and we wanted to see what would happen.
And this is an example of what VC matte is. If it's thin, and it can be matte, but then it can also be super runny in the same piece. Low silica matte. So anytime you add silica to this, it'll run like crazy.
And in case you're interested, we ran a test on the Cinco Rojo just to see what it would.
But it is and a good test because sometimes what they do is they'll put a white slip
and
then you can see it actually happening on the white part as opposed. So that's sometimes what you can do with your tests. Some people will do Robin Hopper used to do tests. They were just too complex for me, but this is what they like. They would have a big tile like this, but big. And then he would paint a white slip and a black slip. And then the clay body. And then he would dip it 3 times. And then after he dipped it, he would take a wash of rutile, wash of cobalt, and wash of iron on there. So you'd see all of this stuff. And then he would do a flat tile also, standing and flat. But it's just like, to me, it was like, it's just too much. I can't handle it.
You know, that is interesting. I always do standing and flat.
Yeah.
Because they are totally different.
Yeah. Well, like if he likes to do tiles, then you know, that's a perfect thing. Then you always have your, but we also kind of have it with these drip trays because in the bottom is the flat. Or some people will do it here. That's one thing. Yeah, he did that. He had a larger bottom and would paint it. And sometimes they texture it if they had textured work. But I don't do that. That's too much. Next victim. Very good work. Next victim.
Okay, so our day 2 stuff, I couldn't find most of the tiles, so...
What?
I don't know what happened to them.
Okay.
We did get... So for these ones, it was trying to correct our measuring mistake from day 1.
Oh.
So we did it correctly.
Nice.
And so they came out a little lighter. This was a day 2 experiment. So we increased the cobalt and decreased the copper.
So in this one, she had titanium, and then she at 7, and then copper at 2, and cobalt at 0.2, and then this one she did copper at 1, and cobalt at 0.5.
So don't do that.
They don't have to be even enough to be not
right. Right, so this must
it
have fallen.
It has one of ours and one of yours on it.
Okay, so I think, what is that one? That must have been the nickel at 1.5.
Okay.
That we tried. I don't know. And that's about it. The other one's just the...
Yeah. Fantastic, thank you. This is good, this is spectacular.
It is, yeah, for sure.
Don't, like, you know what people do when they, I've never gone to grad school for ceramics, but this is what I imagine that they do. They do a test like this early on, and they like it. And then they spend two years making work, doing this exploring, right? Then they have a body of work when they come out. This is what you do. So this could be the entire life's work right here. Or you can save yourself some trouble and just start watching TV and like eating candy. It's a lot less work. And then you die anyway in the end, but who cares? Okay. Next victim. You see what happens when I get tired? I just start vomiting out profanities. Yes. Next. Is this yours?
Yeah, that was my group. We were over here on Friday.
Yeah?
And we tried to do Bill's Best 11.
Okay. Bill's Best 2?
Yeah, Bill's Best 2.
Okay. And then you change, what did you do? You change copper, cobalt?
Yeah. And then nickel, and then here we just played around and put rutile, nickel, and titanium.
That's nice though. That's a version of that one, yeah. Cool.
And this one fell down.
Yeah.
And tried to have fun with the other one.
Tried to steal some glaze from another pot.
Yeah. And I put this here because I liked how the crystalline was on the Cinco Rojo.
Yeah.
In comparison to the
Cinco Rojo. That was cool.
Oh, yeah. That's nice. Very good. Excellent. All right.
No. Okay.
Thank you. Very good. Next one.
Globes, anybody?
That's okay. How about this one?
That's mine. And the Sumer base, and this is with bentonite added.
Just the titanium, yeah. Okay.
Okay, no and color. These two are copper, carbon, rutile.
Nice.
And then this one is rutile or copper.
Okay.
And this is Mike's, I don't know what it is.
It's called crater glaze.
That's what it is.
Do we know how much copper we did?
Yeah, we do.
Let's tell me that.
Four.
Four copper.
12
or two.
Wow.
12
or two. Holy cow.
You guys went over. You guys went off the.
That was a 200 gram batch.
Oh.
By two.
So it's two and six.
Yeah, two and six. Sorry about that.
Yeah. You see why we have groups of two and four?
So we can divide.
Okay.
Yeah. And then, what was this one?
That was bentonite. The titanium's five, so that'd be two and a half.
It was five. Now this one goes here.
You're messing with me now.
What's this one?
Use the same recipe.
Okay. What would we
do? This is more copper.
It's a two, and rutile is six.
Okay, and what's this one?
This is the same. It was supposed
they're
to
two at the same?
They're the same.
I think they're the same.
They're the same.
Yeah.
Okay. Just thicker.
Yeah.
So that's actually an interesting thing, that this looks much different. Even it's the same body, I'm guessing.
Yes, it is.
So then it maybe just ran off. So this was ended up being thicker, looks greener. This ran off more.
Were they in different firings? Different kilns?
No. That's interesting. Mm-hmm. All right, good. And that other guy had the crater glaze. His was like more foamy.
He did his at C2, and that's at C4.
Oh, okay. Good. Excellent. All right, next.
Oh, those are ours from, this is from the first day, our C2 tiles and stuff that we put in the reduction kiln.
Oh, burned. These are, yeah, so we might think, that's why we think they're so gray, we might have over-toasted that. We burnt the turkey.
We'll do it differently next time.
We're going to do it lighter.
Cobalt, apparently you cannot burn.
Yeah, apparently not.
Nothing will change that ever.
What's this glaze called? And now they call it student loan blue.
Yeah, right.
Because then you can sell a lot.
It was just sell blue.
Okay, I got some in there. I'm soaking in acid. After we're done here, I'll get those out. Who?
This is Binger one with. So this is Binger 1, the first recipe. It's got the cobalt of some sort.
One and titanium 7.
And titanium 7. And these are variations on the amount of copper. We added bits of copper. Right? Yes, we added bits of copper and we
from 1% down to 0.25, so not much.
Not much.
Titanium remained the same.
Titanium was the same, so it didn't seem to match. This is, I don't know. It didn't.
It's hard to know the answer is what she's trying to say, because we don't know about heating rate. You know, application could have been varied. Maybe the fluxing of copper could have caused these to go off a little more or not. We're uncertain. You'd probably have to try some more, but they're very nice.
Yeah, they are. Sorry, what?
Dipped?
Brushed.
Brush.
I dipped the tiles, and then these were brushed.
Oh, nice. Really brushed? Yeah. How many coats have you brushed?
That many. Like three. Maybe four, maybe five, I don't know.
Six or seven.
You work for Raytheon?
Yeah. We're more precise there. This is my.
I was a little scared there for a minute.
Jet fighter. Wait a minute. Never mind. Okay.
And then this one is the same banger, but it's got 7%. Wait, no. It's got 6% rutile and 3% copper carbonate. Phone, go away. And then we changed the amounts of rutile on the second day, and.
She went from 3 to 5, and then the copper remained the same at
copper,
3.
Yeah. And yeah, so these
spectacular.
So the rutile, as it increased, made it greener, which I would have thought it was the color.
I think browner. That's the most rutile.
Yeah, this makes the green.
This is the most rutile, and this is the least rutile. And so
I thought it was a progression to the highest.
Oh,
that says 5.
It is.
Oh,
it says 3.
Right. So it gets browner as it went up.
It's probably causing it to crystallize more, pulling copper into the crystal.
Yeah.
I'm guessing. And this could have been thin. This looks thin.
That's 6. That's the most rutile. That's 6%.
Okay. This should actually
should be
up here.
Yeah.
But also it's another firing. We don't know how hot it got. Yeah. That kind of stuff. Yeah. But that you could work with.
Is there a way to account for the crystals being so much larger back here than this? If this were there, this is a much finer crystal pattern.
I think this
pattern.
Is thinner. I think this is much thinner. This is on here good.
Beautiful.
Look at this drip tray.
Gorgeous.
I mean, that's full at the bottom. So that's very thick application. I'm going to say this is fairly thin, barely ran down. See what I'm saying?
That's
so here's what you do. If this is your piece, then you go home and you make that up and put it thin, medium, thick.
Yeah.
And try it. Then you do them, you know, super thick. And then you do your rutile again, and you do copper again. Then you go, or if you wanted to, you do titanium, because titanium's in rutile. Oh, maybe I'll put a little iron in. Now I'm going to explore all around this and figure it out. Okay, do you know this also? Binger is a glaze in the book. It's in the combination section. It's not supposed to be a glaze. It's a cover for other glazes. So who had pictures of their, they put some, oh yeah, so she would put it on like, say, I don't know, spearmint. And then you put this over top of it.
Oh.
And then it juices it up.
Oh.
And so there's another one called, you know, a Fong Chu. He makes these teapots, like say they'll be blue, then he'll put this snow, it's called dirty snow on it.
Oh, yeah.
Basically got titanium in a fluxing glaze. Mm-hmm. And then it runs, so it's a cover also. And there's one called salvation glaze, which you can imagine if your firing was shitty, and then you tried to save your pots. And if they wanted to change hard enough, they could change.
So are these double fired? Or is
they could either be double dipped or double fired. So this is not a good glaze for, you saw how it leaches real bad. That's why it's a cover glaze. Mm-hmm.
Interesting.
But we noticed that it worked for super nice. Okay, very good.
Next
victim.
All right, so we have the fobbies the first day, and I guess what we did yesterday was we soaked these in acid, and we did find that the crystals are showing up a little bit more because they didn't show up much before, and then we decided to test titanium dioxide from 0 to 9%. So at 0, we're getting this. And I'm sorry, they're not in order, but at 9, we're getting this, which is a lot greener.
And opaque.
Mm-hmm. We are, what I do like is there are not many crystals, but the streaks
actually,
on some of them.
Yeah.
Like here.
Super. Oh, yeah, look at that.
Very,
super
very
nice.
Interesting.
This is yeah.
So that's really the titanium dioxide.
So you could even try going more and see if you could get it to do more stuff. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And then because we liked these so much from the winner.
You stole some of their glaze?
Well, that is just their glaze. That's just their glaze. But then we thought, okay, we're going to add some of those colorants to ours. So this is actually, these are the test tiles, but here is with 0.5 cobalt and at 4% titanium dioxide. This is 0.5 cobalt at 9%, same thing with the cobalt, but the titanium at 9. And so it gets a little bit darker, a little bit greener, but it's still a little hot. It's still not, it's not very crystalline, but it just gives more specks than anything.
So like this has, what does this have? 4 copper and 4 titanium.
Right.
And so the copper is like doing weird things as it gets more and more. So it's going to be green at lesser amounts, and then it's going to start to probably form little nuclei there.
There's another one.
What's that? Is that more? 6?
This one is on.
Okay.
Yeah, so that's 6 with teal, 4 titanium dioxide.
Okay.
And we can't see how much.
Oh, so you had 6 rutile and right. 4 titanium. So right. That's 10 of the opacifier. That's a lot.
Ah, is that why?
Yeah, okay. That's a lot.
Okay.
But that's good.
Yeah, and then these are just some of the ready-made Sinair and the VC Matte and the Simair just on things. And then Sue, you should explain.
What you got there?
She did some. That is...
Rafa?
Yes. This is actually BC 1.
BC Matte 1.
Yeah.
Okay. Bill's Best 3.
Bill's Best.
And what liner did you use?
Just glossy white.
So she put glossy on? But look how nice this is. Look.
Really nice.
So if you did a cup to drink out of, mm-hmm. this is the dough. Because now any of your mouth's going to touch here, it's going to be fine. Great transition. I mean, that is like, you ain't getting better now. I'm sorry. That's fantastic.
Oh, wait, tell them what you got here, too.
And this is the Celadon.
Not the liner.
Bigger.
Dipped it into Celadon about that deep, and then waxed the Celadon, and then put the crystalline glaze on the top.
So she's doesn't need to use alumina or bentonite to make stuff. She's used the glaze to catch it. Fantastic. Another thing you can do is, like, if you do stuff like that, you can put a little line of black glaze or blue glaze, and then when this hits it, then it's going to push these colors down. You can do a ton of stuff with this transition. That'll be fantastic. Fantastic work. This, I mean, there's a lot of material here that you can just brush right over. Oh, no, that's not good. No, this is good material. Even if you took this and then did you glaze the inside and then let it run over?
I dipped it about, on this one, yeah. I think I dipped down about.
And then did you wax?
I did not wax it.
No. So then you just dipped it in at the top. You just dipped it in like that?
Right.
One coat.
Right.
Yeah. So what she could do then is like do her white.
Wax it.
Wax it or put a line of cobalt.
That'd be nice.
Put a line of copper.
Yeah.
And then do her dip. Now we're going to get, oh my God, so good.
Watch it float down.
Well, a lot of this is just a clear liner.
It'll move. I just mean, if you kept it down here, your lips are never, you're not going to go, oh. Dainty.
So when you're saying putting a black glaze, John.
What?
When you're saying doing like a line of the black, would you put that under or over?
Either way, but I would start with it. You mean on this one?
Yeah.
I would probably start with it on first because I know this is. I see it rolling over, and see that white line and that tan line. You can see how it's pushing down the Celadon and making it thicker. That made it look like a line. So I'm like, oh, that would be awesome if we could.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So I'd either try one or the other or both. Mm-hmm. I mean.
Did you hear that? Cool.
That's fantastic. Awesome. All right, next.
So I teach a lot of students. I don't want them all to be messing with porcelain because most of them aren't ready yet. So what I did in this whole row is I went porcelain stoneware, porcelain stoneware, porcelain stoneware, etc. But I did identical applications on the two so that you could see what one looks like on one and what it looks on the other. These are all John's Best. They were the recipes we mixed up the day before, but what I did is I applied them differently. Like on this one, I did number one all over it, and then I put three spots of number three, and then I put a ring of number five, and the same here. Wow. And I followed that same pattern all the way up, and the numbers are here if you want them.
What was the best place?
John's best. Bill's best. I know Bill's a John Britt and a Bill Britt, and I mix them up. I'm sorry?
It doesn't matter. What matters here is like what she's doing. It's a good system of showing the differences, doing a systematic approach to glazing. It's fantastic. You don't have to just use one glaze either. You could be mixing up, you know, John's best, Bill's best, Ray Fa. What, you know, that? What's the lady's name? Oh, I forgot her name. She's in my Cone 10 book. She'll do these big pieces, but she does several on there. And I forgot her name, but she's really good.
The one
good.
With all the multicolors?
Yeah.
Wendy
oh my
and
gosh, she's awesome.
Wendy and I were just looking at that.
She's yeah, fantastic.
Five colors on
what?
That.
Not Lisa Orr, right?
No, it's a crystalline lady.
Five glazes she had in that huge pot.
Yeah.
I can't remember.
I'll remember it later. But so you don't have to just stick with your one. You can go. But I like the way, too, she kept track of stuff. She has a system. So next.
These two are Binger and Signar. And I've put dots of. I didn't write it down there. Number 9 and 10.
Some like other glaze.
Number three.
Oh,
the number three color from, or the number three mix of Bill's best on the three spots.
Okay.
And then this is just plain Binger. This is Signar Goldstone. And these are Fa-Re. And I used number three on this one and number two on the other one. So nickel and cobalt.
Beautiful.
Yeah, that's nice.
And this is actually interesting. It looks like the way, remember, didn't I have a picture in the book we talked about on stoneware where this thing gets thin, it got silvery because of the, it nucleated on the grog. So always where it pulled down. So if you could get this to be the right thickness right away, you may get silver straight up off of that one. Nice. Good job. Next.
Yeah, so I did the snare goldstone. I was intent on trying to do something different. Got a little bit of weird results. I did do what she did. I did one row, which is all the tea mix. This row is all the porcelain. This top one, number five, turned out really interesting. It looks like it's just really, really heavy encrusted with the crystals on the top, not quite so much at the bottom. This one I thought came out really interesting.
Yeah.
Because it had this whole red going on here. So I basically variated the red iron oxide and I added titanium dioxide, which is not in the snare goldstone at all. So,
and the reason that she did that was because in the crystalline we all had titanium, and these are iron crystalline, but there weren't any, so she thought she would just try it, combining the concept.
Right. So it looks
and
like.
And there's some of that. Look at that nice crystal, and there's some of that here too.
Yeah, I saw that too. So the 36, the original recipe called for 32 red iron. I went ahead and upped it to 34 and 36. The 36 being this top row, number five, and then. The number four, the 34 also came out kind of interesting. When I had a smaller amount of the RIO with the titanium dioxide, didn't quite do as much of a
called,
hit.
This is called iron yellow when it gets, so, but you see, that's still got a ton of iron.
It's
the glaze will like eat up the color.
It's an interesting contrast. I mean, if you're looking for a yellow that's a good contrast, well, on your texture, that's kind of cool. And this one too, at the bottom. So.
And you've got crystals. Right here at the top.
At the top, yeah, that turned out.
Where it's thinned out, too. Yeah.
Yeah. So something to explore with. Yeah.
You can see it on the side.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
All right, next victim.
So this is Hi-Ho Silver?
Hi-Ho Silver.
Yeah.
Oh, that's yours?
I ran the Hi-Ho with every frit, like possibility, and they all came out virtually the same. So I put one out there because it's kind of like looking at all of them.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So it came out this gold. Is that because of the stone of the clay it's on, or it's just?
I mean, this sits on B mix, and
I don't know. I don't know if I would call that gold my. I don't
trying
know.
To be.
Yeah, it's trying to be something, but it's.
He's trying to get goldy, bronzy, silvery, and he had like 50 manganese, so he buried
and
that.
The, it was the
copper sulfate
that was. It was foaming up and making a weird amorphous mass.
So if he refires that and reduces it or soaks it a little longer,
okay. And for sure, what he's going to do now, so you can get these just in an E1 firing. You don't need a bunch of soaking, but we thought we'd try it anyway because some people got it. So he's going to go home and try it. He's going to go get some crystals of cobalt sulfate. They're blue crystals that people use in Miracle-Gro type stuff.
Yeah.
And so he's going to try that and see if he can find it. But he's getting close, but he worked really hard.
Which one?
They were all the same. C4.
Not reduction.
No, none of them were
this
reduction.
Does not represent all the only tile he did.
No,
he probably did 50 tiles.
What's that?
Do you have all those tiles here?
Yeah, but they all
look like that.
Yeah, you can look at them all if you want, though.
They
I've
all
got like 20.
He's right.
Okay. Thank you.
Next.
Victim.
So I did mostly the Samir face, let's see, and then I did it with 5% titanium on my colored porcelain, and it pulled out some of the color. This is Samir with 9% neodymium, and you can't really see it in here, but out in the sun you can see more of the purple.
What's that stuff called? Photo
iridescence.
Yeah, like it, and the titanium is like that too. In the dark and light, it will look different.
This is 8% titanium with 1.5 red iron oxide. Then I did the silica carbide with the tin and the copper, and it didn't do anything. It didn't do local reduction at all. And then there's another one in the middle with copper and black nickel.
Okay, let me just chime in here. Yep. She's trying to make copper red and electric with silicon carbide. But maybe because the glaze, like what I would do if I was her is I would try it with a glaze that works. See if I'm getting it. Then I would try maybe more in here because you see the way this ate up the iron. This looks like a celadon with like 4 iron, but it's really 30 something. This, so I might have to put in 2 silicon carbide to get actually some residual things to work. So don't give up on that.
What ate up what?
I'm just saying it
burned off?
It goes into the melt and doesn't come out like
the others.
Like a Temeku. Temeku is 10% iron. When you have enough silicon alumina, it will form blacks or browns. But when you have it really fluid, they call it bleaching iron, but it's basically, I just call it, it eats it up. Like it'd be like a stain that you put in and you can't see it anymore. Yeah. So
could it be just changing the state of iron in there?
Huh?
Could it be just changing the state of the iron to a yellow iron oxide?
I just don't know. I did this test once. Ian Curry has a book called Stoneware Glazes. Super good book. And in there he has some triaxials that he does with iron. The iron remains the same and it goes from black and brown to yellow, but the same amount of iron. It's the aluminum and silica that help make it. Okay, what you got?
The one that's sandwiched in between is 2% copper with 0.5 black nickel. And is this it? So yeah, you can't really see on the test tile, but it's got a little green.
So that's the Samaras with that added to it?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, my test
tile
became friends.
She these are very delicate, and we fired them too hot for her clay.
Oh yeah, this is my casting slip. This is cone 6 porcelain.
And we decided that if she wanted to keep this, if she liked this, she may start using a cone 10 casting slip to fire to cone 7 or 8 like we did, mm-hmm. And then she wouldn't get the slumping problem. So then that's another whole, or you would try to bring it down to 6, which means we think we may lose some of this spectacularness because we've tried this. We did like 5 firings, I told you, and they weren't all this spectacular until we got this hot cycle. So it's really not cone 6 crystal, cone 8. There's probably some 7 in there. Well, there were some at 6, but you know, this is spectacular.
So this last line here is a color progression with the teal stain that I used in this clay body. And that's what's on this. And I went and I did the base with 5% titanium and then did increments of my stain. And I started at 9.
She has nice crystal here.
And it's built best. So.
And then you see how the crystal is trying to form, but you don't get any definition. So we think it's because in stains there's aluminum and silica that's inhibiting growth. Or chrome.
What's it?
It's a cobalt aluminate blue spinel, silica fumed. What's that mean?
I don't know. That's what the MSDO says.
Oh. But I thought you said, is it the cobalt aluminous blue?
No, it's all of
all
this.
Of this. Oh, that means there's
80,
20. I see. There's cobalt and chrome. There's alumina. Silicate, that alumina and silica, zinc, iron, chrome. So there's a lot of things in this stain. Very small amounts of, but the main thing that is inhibiting the growth, well, it could be chrome, but it can also be alumina and silica. Anytime you have that's called a spinel. And so that's inhibiting our crystal movement. It's like a refractory we're adding. Okay?
I went to 1% to 5%.
Fantastic. Nicely done. Next victim.
Okay, that's me. And I worked with Larissa. And on the first one, we did Bill's Best. And so I went back and grabbed our glaze. We also did some Samir. And I combined the glaze mixtures and to see how working with, really, once we had gotten our glazes mixed, how they would work together. And so, of course, this was what everybody else has, and so I'm not gonna really talk about this one that much. This is a combination. We have this here over a Bill's Best.
Bill's Best 3.
And if you look inside,
nice.
It has, this was glazed with the clear, and then it sunk down.
That's actually very good, you guys. You see that? It's a streaky, you can come and look at it later. That goes along with what she did, so you could actually incorporate that idea on the outside, like, Put on the clear, but then paint a strip of this, and then see, get that running down.
And next. So this is also, this is the Bill's Best as well, and the blue that was with it, which was the cobalt.
Nice.
And so we mixed in our test tiles from the first day, we had a blue, and I combined the Bill's Best and added the blue on top, and this is a lot of glaze, let me tell you. And so I got a lot of crystals down here, but we knocked it off and then got these beautiful crystals.
That's beautiful.
All the way around.
Yeah.
This one was green. It has gorgeous on the inside, a little dripping going on. Nice little ring here. And then some also some run down inside, but didn't get that many crystals. I'm not sure why, but probably it all ran off down here.
Very good.
Should have been a little bit more. This was really interesting, probably too much glaze, but it has an interesting appeal.
Are you selling this?
Watercolor.
The curve appeal is excellent on this next model.
Walk up and curb appeal, you know. I've been watching a lot.
It's starting to come
I
out.
I see it's coming out, yeah.
We've been redoing our house. I think it's coming out.
I can tell.
So, happen here.
That's okay. You got the idea. She did nice overlap. And these are actually really nice the way these combine.
These are all overlap glaze upon glaze. And this one, all the glaze rolled down.
Okay.
And
yeah, that's what you would do probably, but not too much. But I would, just some of them are
that
like
will
that.
Also knock down the luster though.
Yeah, exactly.
This one I thought he had made the comment, so this is all John's fault. he said if the pot was thicker, it probably would hold the crystal. And I said, okay, well, I'm going to try that. So I loaded on the glaze, and as you can see it, hell no, crystals.
Well, and it could be so, like, remember I said that guy who just did one square inch of glaze, a gram? So then that doesn't run. Sometimes when it starts running, it just pulls everything off. You have to figure
so
that out.
So maybe less is better.
The thickness is critical.
Yeah, thickness is super critical. And sometimes thicker does not make it better.
That's right. Obviously that was a case here.
All right, very good.
I don't know who, but we haven't figured out whose this is. It's just a Sumer.
That's a Sumer with neodymium.
Oh, it's just Connor.
Okay, next.
Yesterday, we did a few different things, and it got so confusing I forgot to dip some of the other tests that we did because we got sidetracked with these. But yeah, so we took the, whoever was at this, that table yesterday with the Sumer base with the, I think it was 3% copper and 7%.
2% copper.
Well, they, I think, used maybe 3%. Either way, looked at that, said that looks great, but let's go for like blue crystals instead of green crystals on a green background. So added a little cobalt at 0.25% to get blue crystals.
It was that guy, right?
Yeah, it's kind of.
The amazing.
So this is 2 copper, 0.5 cobalt, 7 titanium.
Right? Yes.
Did you sieve this?
No.
So this is just like ours, but why does yours look so good?
Yeah.
It is on T-Mix.
He's promoting a clay pot. Yeah. Can you believe this shit?
He sells it. He's at Trinity. He works at Trinity.
I don't get a commission.
I don't know why that looks so spectacular.
He ran that submersion blender forever.
Now wait a minute.
Oh,
I do blend things very thoroughly when I mix them.
I mean, I watched him over everyone else, and I thought.
Wait. You added the titanium dioxide. Did you say that?
Yeah, 7.
Yeah,
7.
But the other thing I did.
Hold on. What are you saying?
One dip. All the way down, and then another dip about halfway.
Okay.
Oh.
It's almost like you live
in the. I just don't. I mean, I'm like, wow, but something he did.
He's a.
Maybe we should measure this.
It was also. It was also sagging, so it was on the top shelf of the kiln on this side, and it was.
It
was flat. It was so it was more horizontal.
Well,
look.
But it ended up that way.
It's on this piece too.
See, I think this is also this is the primary crystal, and I think these are called the secondary crystals that form around here. That is spectacular.
They're gorgeous. It's gorgeous.
Look at this.
And I have this studio's green celadon up to here. And so it went over that.
Nice. The bottom.
What body is that?
So the celadon is from the top down halfway or bottom up halfway?
Bottom up halfway.
Whoa. Wait, why is it green at the top then?
She did from the liner. Because that, as I lined the inside, I did a little, just slightly on the rim.
Okay.
A little concern about food safety.
Sure.
Oh.
Beautiful. Good,
really good. So the binger is way too thick on these two.
He got a crystal on that guy. On the middle guy.
It'd be nice like for limoncello.
Yeah.
Shot of Kahlua.
In Texas we call that Kahlua.
Super nice, because you could control this and change it. That's good. This is good. Don't feel
awesome.
You guys should not feel bad about any of this stuff. I just noticed this was so different, and so there's something happened that made it different. So
is all your stuff T-Mix, Connor?
Yep.
Yeah.
Wow. Is it the magic bentonite?
Was we did put bentonite in it.
Two pluses, but I just did it because of my first horrible experiences mixing crystalline glazes where they all just settled out like rocks.
Yeah.
And so when I don't see clay in a recipe, I put 2% bentonite in there just in case.
Oh, so that could have helped stiffen it a little. So that's a good idea. Either try adding bentonite to yours or try mixing them well. But you may not want to sieve them all because no one has. Somebody should try sieving things. Wow, that's really nice. And see if we get a difference of sieving and everything.
So we could add 2% bentonite to this and maybe it would
sell. Exactly.
Instead of go down.
Okay, did we do good?
Yeah.
Yeah. Good, good. We did more than good.
Yes, I think so.
Okay, so I don't know what we're doing now, but I know we have to do, do we do